As always, it's your boy, Hey Fam Measley G. Y'all already know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you through the video.
What's good? I'm back, y'all. And just real quick, I'm in the basement, so forgive the echo, but I'm about to go over a few of the things that I grabbed this weekend. But first, something that got copped earlier this week, the Off-White Converse Chuck Taylors. So it came boxed pretty nice, as you can see. This package, this pair came from Dover Street Market. And this was bought by my boy, Hersey Molina. You can catch him on Instagram at Street Kings or Real Street Kings. His IG will be linked in the description below. He does buy Yeezys. He buys pretty much anything. So as you can see, these came real nice. Dover Street Market, what is this? So receipt for the purchase. So this shoe ended up costing $145 with tax, shipped $145. And I did manage to let it go for just under $1,000. So that's a nice good come up that helps with other Jordan pickups. So it came completely bubble wrapped, and I have to say, they did wrap this up nicely. You see the box, like your standard off-white boxes. And this right here is a size 6.5 men's and 8.5 women's. All right, Chuck Taylor, and the color is clear white white. See if you can get closer in on that. Bam. All right, let's get into this kit right away off top. You got extra laces, you got black, you got white. You got another white with green. What is this white one? This is just all white. Black with orange. And then you also have white in here already. Now, first impression of this shoe is, from the pictures, I thought this shoe was dope. And with it in hand, it still is dope. Okay, you got your zip tie. You got your right foot, you got your left foot, all right? Now this shoe is clear, so I think what makes this shoe really is gonna be the socks you wear. So the socks you wear is what's really gonna make this this shoe flick. And everything is clear on it. And that's probably why this shoe got delayed, why it's the last of the 10, is because they have production issues trying to make this part see-through. Oh yeah, it's like a nice little netting. It's breathable, it's not like a hard plastic. This is not gonna make your feet sweat. It doesn't seem like it at all. You got your typical branding right here on the inside. And all in all, this has been vulcanized. I think this shoe is very dope. I wish I could've got a pair for myself and my mom. That's what I was really aiming to do, was get a pair for me and her. This would've been a really dope pickup, but I got a 6.5, man, this is my mom's size. Made a mistake, but it's sold already, moms. Anyway, Chuck Taylors, Off-White, give you a closer look up. So if you are looking for a pair of Melo 9 size 9.5, Holla at your boy Measley G. The number is linked in the description. I think I did a video on these already. You know what? I don't think I did. I copped them, but because I believe Fine Line, Unbreakable, everybody got to the video before me, I never posted a video of the personal pair. So y'all didn't see it. So for those of you guys who didn't see it, it's brown. The number 15 on the back represents Mellow. This shoe basically represents, I guess, his one of his stings, his championship run at Syracuse University. And I really like the gold accents on here coming down to where the bottom plate with this milky bottom sole. So this shoe is very dope. I'll give you a quick close-up on it, and then we'll get to the next pickups. Now that was the Jordan 9 Mellow, the toss out the side with those all whites. And the next two pickups, no need for review, but I just want to give a nice little shout out to my homie John McLean. He blessed me with another Katrina. Says 10.5, so y'all already know. Personal pair, not playing, and these smell so delicious. So yes, another pair of Katrinas. Appreciate you, fam. Taking care of your boy, Measley G, holding it down. So he looked out for me. Somebody who you know usually hits me up if he needs anything, but this time he came out for me and he looked out. So that was added to as well. Also, I stopped by that outlet, Nike. And if you see on this box, there's a stamp on this box. Cameraman, come closer. A little bit closer. Zoom in. Zoom in. Do you see the stamp on this box right here? Imperfect. Okay? It's a Nike box, but on the tab, we have a 10.5 Air Jordan 11 Retro Low. All right? This is a closing ceremony. And what that box, what that stamp on the box means is that this is a B grade. And also, and I'll give you a close-up in a minute of it too. Actually, we'll do it right now. Close-up of it. If you look in there, you'll see a stamp, a little blue stamp. See that? That blue stamp is basically letting them know that this shoe has imperfections that did not allow it to pass and go through retailers. So these pairs have come out. I tried them on. I don't really know what the flaw is on these shoes yet. I mean, you can look at the midsoles a little bit. You know what I mean? Midsoles don't look as perfect. But other than that, I'm going to beat this shoe up. So it really doesn't. Oh, okay. I think I see the imperfection. It's on the back heel here. This back heel on this right shoe is off. So imperfection, but who cares? These ones sell for $139, and I ended up using a $20 birthday coupon my mama sent me. So bam, $120 shoes, I'm just gonna beat these right away. Summertime beaters, okay? Now, what I'm really happy about is this weekend's pickups. See the two white boxes? See Jordan 1 box, okay? Now, if you take a look at these sizes, you see 12, you see 12, you see 10.5. A woman's 12 is a man's 2.5, a man's 10.5. But like those satins, these come an extra half a centimeter bigger, which means toe spacing-wise, you're gonna have more toe room in the shoe, right? Now, we all know what the homages look like. There's no need to do close-ups or reviews. But I do want to pull these out because I do want to show something to make a point. Alright. Now, this pair, I have no idea which pair this is, so let's take a look. This is the Chicago colorway women's rubber. And look at this. nice. I have some flaws or some issues that I do think is wrong with these shoes, and I'll go ahead and I'll stress them right now. While the leather on these is extremely nice, I do feel like the white leather is appropriate with other white leather. The only difference is it's thinner here. So while this feels buttery and everything like that, I think they used thinner padding when making this shoe. So that way the shoe is thinner and they could get away with more. Also, if you look at the bottom of it, and you see they're both red soles, and these are supposedly both the same size. So if this is a woman's 12, which is a man's 10.5, look at the difference in width. Look at that. This shoe is way thinner than this shoe at the foot base here. And if you look at that, and that's where I really think the problem is. So while I have extra toe spacing in this shoe, my foot doesn't spread out wide enough. So this shoe fits real snug. So these women's shoes, they are making these shoes for not just women, but women with thin feet. You can't have wide feet in these shoes at all, especially with how you get in the shoe with your ankle support. That's gotta zip up. You can't have wide ankles, wide feet, and get in this shoe. Even if it is your shoe size, it's still gonna be an uncomfortable fitting. That's why I got rid of those satins, and I didn't think it was gonna be the exact same issue with these, so I cut the 12s, but it seems to be that it is the same issue with these. They do fit. I did try these on in the store, and I don't care, I still like it. So this is the Chicago colorway. White red. This zipper concept is nice to get in. And put both shoes together look like. Boom. Now they did move the Jordan thing to the Jordan Wing logo to the back heel versus to the side. So that's a major change. The shoelacing to the side, which I don't really think makes a difference because you use the zipper to get in this shoe. So this is the Chicago colorway. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment section. Is this a pass? Is this a drop? If you're 8.5, if you're a man, if you can fit these, let me know what your thoughts are on about picking these up. Rebels are a hate. Are you too stuck on the old ways of how Jordans came out? Let me know. Also, like we said, we love these homages. We love the homages. This is a personal pair. This will be going on the foot sometime sooner or later. And the shoe that I really like the most out of this whole little Rebel collection would have to be the top three Rebel. This shoe is dope. I'm gonna pull out both pairs. I like these better than the Chicago colorway. You got your red toe box, you got your blue toe box, vice versa with the heels. Again, Jordan emblem on the back. It's more visible, it looks better in red than it actually does in blue, in my opinion. But I do like the blue toe box better than this one. So we also have top threes dropping. I believe it's the reverse top threes dropping later this year. So this is what we got. This was this weekend's drop, guys. Let me know what you think. I'm gonna pull them all out again. This is everything I ran through this weekend. Everything. I'm very happy with my pickups. Like I said, these shoes are kind of snug. I'm not 100% certain if I'm going to keep them or not. The top threes, I think I definitely might keep. These Chicagos are up for grabs. So, Hamish Mahomes, Chicago Rebels. Top three Rebels. That's what we got. We got some of these. This was a great weekend, guys. Great summer shoes. Great things to go forward with. Great shoes to move forward with. Only thing, like I said, is for sale is that Jordan 9 Mellow. Please, the number is linked in the description below. If you do want that, take that off my hands. Once again, I want to thank my homie John for these Katrinas. I really appreciate that. Those off-whites are super dope. Anything you guys want to see in the future, let me know. I'll see if I can get my hands on it early to give you guys an in-hand review. Whether if it's mine or I borrow it for someone, you know I'm going to give it to you to show. It's your boy, Measley G, In Tony B2's words, checking in, checking out.